Hello and welcome to another edition of The Big Leap from Mirae Asset. Today we have with us Mr. Pawan Kumar Agrawal, who is the founding member of InvestGuru.in. He is an MBA finance and also an NISM certified financial planner. He has been in the financial services industry for more than two decades now and has been running his firm for the last 15 years. We are very happy to be associated with Mr. Agrawal for the last almost a decade now. Today, while the whole industry has been talking about SIPs being a very important part of the investment culture in India, we are very happy to say that Mr. Agrawal has been one of the pioneers who started his whole firm as the bedrock being SIPs. So while the whole industry is now talking about SIPs and the power of SIPs for investors, we are very happy to share with the audience today that Mr. Agrawal was actually somebody who started his whole business from SIPs. If you remember when we used to talk for the last one decade, I remember that he was one of the very few ones in the industry to talk about only SIPs being the main part of the discussion with any investor across the industry. So we'll start on that conversation with you, Mr. Agrawal. We would like you to share that what has been your start for the mutual fund journey? How did you start this organization? What has been your experience till now on that?
So Mayukh, first of all, I would like to thank Mirae Asset for giving us this opportunity and express our views and to explain more about ourselves. I was working in 2002-2003, I was working with a financial services firm, and my observation and experience was that at that time, a lot of focus was done on sales and lesser on client experience.
Absolutely.
Servicing was almost non-existent. So 95% of the organization's focus was to get the sales and generate sales, basically generate business. Second, I observed was that a lot of companies, I would not say all, but a lot of companies did not focus on the employee development. So they hired the employees which were already experienced in a particular field, and if they suited their business model, they continued with the employees. Otherwise, you know, they were asked to leave.
Sure.
So keeping these two things in mind, I thought that rather than working in those kind of companies, it is better to actually start one's own business. Okay. So idea was that to create a company where we can give solutions to the clients and actually continue with them for 10, 20, 30 years, which is the basic foundation of our financial services being into business. Second part was that our company should be such that whoever joins us as a team member, he should never leave us because of us. So idea was that it is our responsibility that if somebody decides to join us, then actually we should take care of his development. Okay. That he joins at X level and we have to foresee how and what he will be doing after 3 years, and accordingly we train and develop the person.
Sure.
So idea was to create a company which gives a very good experience to the investors and also to the employees as well. At that time our tagline was commitment for life, so that meant for investors as well as for employees, that once we are related to each other, then we will remain for you always. So on that basis, we started.
So this you are talking about when you started the firm 15 years back,
that
you
were 2003, 16 years
yes.
back.
Yes, so 16 years back. So you were very clear that it was as much a value proposition for investors as it should be for the internal stakeholders, for employees. So what would you say has been the key milestones during your journey?
When we talk about milestones, business numbers come to the forefront.
Yes.
So when we started in 2003, till 2008-09, and we were selling almost 9,000-10,000 policies per year at that time. And in the meantime, we developed our mutual fund business, but that was trickling at that time. In 2010, this translated into completely changing the model from life insurance to mutual funds.
Okay.
And therein we started the mutual fund with SIP as primary focus. And over this period, we have come to a place where we are running almost 8,000 live SIPs. We have in mutual funds more than 5,000 live customers, though overall our customer base is almost 29,000. As a milestone, in 2008-09, at one point we had 15 offices in 12 cities. Though currently we operate only from this, because now technology has taken the forefront. And we believe that from one office with the help of technology, we can serve the clients across the globe. Business-wise, we are currently around 250 crores AUM. The big thing that happened for us is that in 2014, we launched our website by the name InvestGuru. Till that time, we were getting business only from referrals. But this launch of this site completely transformed our business volumes. So in next 3 years, we added almost 2,000 clients from across the globe because of the help of the queries that we received from the website. So technology has played a very important role, and we have been able to do a lot of things with the help of technology that we have developed, and that also we have developed in-house. It is not an outsourced technology. Everything we do in technology is in-house. So that is again one of our key achievements, in last 10-12 years.
So what I would see as a key learning from this small discussion is that from a physical presence, when you reduced it, your business actually grew up, which is very anti to a normal thinking which you would think in any business expansion, that you need to be geographically there to be able to expand. Actually, you expanded when you actually reduced your footprint, but you used technology to leapfrog that growth. So I think that's a very key learning for our audience today. What do you think have been the challenges till now, and what do you foresee the challenges for the whole distribution landscape, and what would be your views on that? So if you could share with us on that.
When I talk about some past challenge, the biggest challenge that we have faced till now was the change in the ULIP guidelines in 2010. You can imagine we were running 15 offices. Our monthly expense was around 25 lakhs. The brokerage rate in a ULIP product was around 30-35%. And from that, suddenly, within a day, it came down from 35 to 5%.
Okay. So that's a disruption to manage.
That was a big disruption because of the regulation that we have already faced. Okay. Our monthly revenue came down from 30 lakhs to 4 lakh rupees. So when you are running a business of 25 lakh rupee expense and your revenue comes to 4 lakhs, you can imagine the kind of disruption that happened. So what we learned from that was that never believe what is going to happen in your business, at least from the regulation side. So idea was to build up a business that whatever happens, you are able to scale higher. And I can very proudly say that we were flexible and agile enough to actually completely shift our model from 30% brokerage to actually 30 paisa brokerage product. It took us 3-4 years to actually stabilize and come to a certain level. But today I can say that was actually a very good challenge that happened to us. Because I believe that we have become much stronger as a business, as a process. We are much stronger than what we were at that time. Even today, we have a lot of regulatory issues in the industry. But my sincere belief is that overall regulations are better for the overall industry in long term. Okay. In short term, they create disruption. But then that is a challenge, but again, an opportunity. In financial services, in investment advisory, I believe that if we are able to create the right value proposition to the client, then I don't think we have to worry about the regulations. Because ultimately, the client experience with your firm or your business will decide whether he will stick to you, whatever the regulations are.
You talked about 29,000 investors who are currently associated with your firm. What would be your investment mantra or your secret in terms of wealth creation which you share with investors, or that is how you think that after 15 years this has been the main key points on wealth creation which you talk to any investor or anybody who looks at the mutual fund environment?
Our philosophy since beginning has remained same, and we believe that this is helping the investors already to create wealth.
Sure.
First is that we have to consider wealth creation as a long journey. It is not a 1 or a 2 year aspect, but it's a 10, 15, 20 year journey. And any journey has, certain milestones and certain stop points. So similarly, a 20 year investment horizon includes a 2 to 3 year horizon. Okay. And that is how you complete a 20 year journey. We have seen that investors and we as an advisors, if we are focusing on 2-3 years at a time, and creating the right experience for the investor over a 2 to 3 year horizon, then that investor sticks to the investment. He sticks to his own discipline, and that helps him to allocate more money in the investment because he's getting a good experience. And more money with the right experience means that his wealth overall grows. So rather than being very return oriented, high return oriented, which comes in a flash and which may go away also. So idea is not to focus too much on high returns, but a consistent performance of investments which are aligned to his goals and financial needs, because he can relate more with his financial needs. So investments, if they are aligned with financial needs, and if you keep on giving a consistent experience, then that journey keeps on continuing. And that is how he achieves his goals also. He feels satisfied that whatever he did actually got the desired results. And in the overall process, his prosperity, grows. And our theme of InvestGuru is actually prosperity with peace.
I saw that.
So prosperity, if it comes with, headache, or, if it comes with uneasiness, there is no point of having that kind of prosperity. So our theme is prosperity with peace. And that, I think, comes with more of consistency. And to keep on getting satisfied on every, 2 to 3, 4 year milestone. And that gives longevity to your investment.
So last question, a lot of our viewers will be mutual fund professionals, distributors, advisors. What could be your key advice to people who look at this as a profession, as a source of income? Because now you have been in the industry for more than 2 decades, so you would have certain amount of experience, so we would like you to talk about that.
There are a lot of people who are already doing very good work in our industry.
Absolutely.
And if I have that wisdom or, experience, 2-3 things I can say. One is that advisors should actually read a lot. And they should read especially books written by investors who are managing global money for last 50, 60 years. Reason being because they have seen different kind of cycles, and lot of wisdom you can get from their experiences, because the experience of our industry is not too much. It is, if we meet people, normally the experience is 5, 10, 15 years. It actually is not sufficient in my opinion. So reading is one thing which advisors should take seriously. And second thing which is universal is that they should be true to their client. That is front and foremost, and not worrying about, delivering too much high return, or thinking about their own income. Means rather than getting technical, they should primarily focus on how to build a client relationship. And as I said before, when you look at long-term relationship, please understand long-term will come only with certain short-term milestones. So focus on long-term relationship with short-term milestones, and your business will fly.
Thank you, Mr. Agrawal, for the opportunity today. For our viewers, you have heard Mr. Agrawal talking about disruption, about scale, about technology being an important part of his advice and his organization. I'm sure that the viewers would have learned a lot from this episode. And thank you again for watching this episode, and we look forward to presenting the next one very soon to you.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.